Hello guys, welcome back to Techdose, and in this video we will see the wine selling problem, and we will solve this problem by using backtracking as well as dynamic programming. So let us look at the problem statement. The problem says that you have n bottles of wine with given profit margins. So in this case, let us assume that we have 5 bottles arranged from left to right, and these are the profits which you would get if you sell these items in the first year. So, as the wine gets older, it is assumed that it will be sold for Y times the number of years have passed after it is being manufactured. Okay. The first year profit margins are mentioned as 2, 4, 6, 2, 5 for these 5 bottles. If you see it in the second year, then in the second year, it will get doubled and the profit will be 4, 8, 12, 4 and 10 and so on. If you see after n number of years, then it will be n times, the profit will become n times. So this is one of the constraint. Another constraint is that you can sell the bottle either from the left hand side or from the right hand side. You cannot sell any bottle from the middle at random. You can only sell the end points, that is the end bottles. In this case, you can sell either 2 or 5. So this is the second constraint. Now, what is your goal? The goal is to maximize the profit. In what order will you sell in order to get the maximum profit? So this is the entire problem. Let us solve this example in order to get a better understanding. So we had 5 bottles and these are the profit margins, and let's say we are selling these 2 in the first year. Then what will be the profit? It will be 2 into 1, which will be equals to 2. If we sell this, let's say 5 in the second year, then what will be the profit? It will be 5 into 2, which will be equals to 10. If we sell this 2 in the third year, then the profit will be 2 into 3 because the profit margin will be tripled and it will be 6. Now, if we sell this 4 in the fourth year, then what will be the profit? It will be 4 into 4, it will be 16. Now, we are left with only 6, so it will be sold in the fifth year and it will be equals to 6 into 5, which will be 30. Now, if you add all these profits, then it will come out to be 64. And this is the maximum profit as I have already calculated it. Okay, so this is the maximum profit which will come. If you sell these items according to the given constraints, then the maximum profit will be 64. You can't get more than this. So our question is to find this maximum profit. And the second question which might come is to find the sequence in which you will sell it. So let us see how can you solve it by using recursion. Actually, if you see this, these are the bottles. Now, in the first attempt, you can sell either the first bottle or the last bottle. So, you have two choices. At each point, you will be having two choices. So, let's say you will be selling this left bottle. Then, what will be the profit margin? Let's say this is the array wine. Okay. Now, it will be wine at start. Let's say we have two pointers, start and this is end. It will be wine at start into the number of years after which we are selling. Initially y will be equals to 1, plus we will be calling this function max profit recursively, and there what we will do is we will pass this entire array wine, as well as we will increase these starting points. Since we have assumed that we have sold the first bottle, therefore we will assume that our array size is now 4. So, what will be the starting point? It will be S plus 1. What will be the ending point? It will be the same. And your year will increase by 1. So, this will denote your first option. That is, if you sell the first bottle. Now, you can have a second option. And this will be stored in the right variable, which will be wine profit at end multiplied by the number of years which have elapsed. Now, the maximum profit function will be called recursively. And there we will pass this wine array. The starting point will be the same, that is, this will be the starting point, but the ending point will decrease by one value, since we have assumed here that we are selling this 5 at the first point. So our ending value will come to 2 and your year will elapse by one value. Since in a single year you can sell only one bottle of wine, this is the constraint which I forgot to mention. So in a single year you will sell only one bottle of wine. Now what we will do is we will return the maximum value of this left and right value. So this is how we calculate by using recursion. This is the three-step process. Now what will be the time complexity of this method? The time complexity will be at each point you are making one out of these two choices. So you will be like forming a tree structure. So what is the time complexity of it? The time will be 2 to the power n minus 1. Because if you have n number of nodes, then only if you are left with a single bottle, you won't have to make a choice. Otherwise, if you have more than one bottles, then you will have to make one out of the two choices. So the time complexity will be big O of 2 to the power n minus 1, which will be 2 to the power n. And this is exponential time. So how can we decrease this time? We can use dynamic programming approach in order to decrease the time. So let us look at the code for backtracking. This is the code for backtracking. I hope you are able to understand the method. Here from the main function, this max profit function has been called, and we are sent with the wine array as well as the starting and ending points with the year number. So if the starting and ending points are same, then we won't have to make a choice and we will just return the calculated value y multiplied by wine at start or wine at end, whatever you write. Otherwise, if starting and ending points are not the same, that means you have more than one bottle of wine. In that case, you will have two choices, either to include the left end bottle or to include the right end bottle. If you are selling the left end bottle, then this line will store the profit margin if you sell the left end bottle first. And this line will store the profit margin if you sell the right end bottle first. These are the two choices, and after that, what will be done is the maximum profit out of these two choices will be returned, since that was our goal, to maximize the profit. We already saw that this process will take exponential time. Now, how can we improve this process by using dynamic programming? Now, in order to solve this by using dynamic programming, we will make a DP table, and this is our DP table, which will contain the rows as the starting point and the columns as the ending point. This says that if you write DP of 1, 3, then actually in the entire array, whatever size it may be, we are actually storing the maximum profit by selling the bottles from first index to the third index. Okay, so I hope you are able to understand it. Suppose we are taking this 2, 4, 6, 5 and we are writing DP at 1, 3, then this will be the max profit which will be earned by selling 4, 6, 5 these many number of bottles according to our given constraint. And if I write DP of 2, 3, then this array will reduce to size of 2, only 6, 5. So I hope you are able to understand it. The left hand side is denoted by the row number here, and the right hand side is denoted by the column number, which is end. Okay. Now the first thing which we will do is we will make the DP table, which will be of size n by n, where n is the number of bottles, and then we will fill the entire table with value minus 1, which will denote that we have not calculated that cell value. Okay. We will solve this problem by using the memoization technique. So we need to make only a slight change to this code. First, let me make the change and then we will see why it will work. Okay, so the first step which we need to do is we need to write a line above this s equals to e. So we need to check that if dp at starting and end is not equals to minus 1, since we have already set the entire dp table as minus 1, indicating that the current cell value is not calculated. If it is calculated, this means that if the DP table cell is calculated from start to end, then we will just return the DP table value from start to end. By doing this, what we are doing is when this calculation has already been done, then we will not be repeatedly doing the same calculations again and again. This will save us a lot of time. Now, if this calculation was not done, then these lines will be run. Okay. And the left and right will also be calculated. After that, what we need to change is, we need to change this line. Instead of writing this line, we will store the value dp at s to e will be equals to maximum value of left, right. So DP at S2E will now be storing maximum of left comma right, whatever value comes as maximum. And after that, we will just return this DP at SE. Now by doing this, what we are doing is, first we had already checked that DP solution is calculated or not. If it is calculated, then we will just return the value. And in this case, we are just storing the calculated value, the maximum of the calculated value in our DP table, so that the next time when this same calculation is required, we will just return it from the first line here. So this is the entire DP code by changing this backtracking code. I hope you were able to understand the backtracking approach. If you understood the backtracking approach, then this will be a cakewalk. So now let us see why this DP solution will work and optimize our solution. So I have taken a smaller example, 2465. This is the profit margin for 4 wine bottles. And as you can remember, the constraint that we can sell from either the left end or the right end, and only one bottle can be sold each year. So I have made the tree diagram by making all the choices. Now what will be the choice options? In the first year, what you can do is, you can either select 2 or 5. So we will have 2 branches. The left branch is saying that if we select this bottle 2, then we will be left with only 465. So that's why we have 465 here. Now when we are at 465, we can either sell 4 or 5. If we sell 4, then we will be left with 65, and so on. So I hope you are able to understand this diagram. Now after seeing this diagram, how can we fill this DP table and make use of this table and reduce our time complexity? Now let us calculate the profit. If we see this left hand side, then here we have selected this 2. Now it was a recursive approach, okay, so it will all be stored in a stack. We are making a choice of 2, so this array size will reduce by 1. Now again we are making a choice of 4, so this array size will again be reducing by 1 size. We are selecting 6 here, so again array size will decrease by 1 size. At last we are left only with 5. So in this case, what will be the profit? Actually our number of years is equals to the number of labels in this tree. So when we are at 5, this is year equals to 4. So what will be the profit which we will gain when we sell this 5 at last? It will be 5 into 4, which will be 20. Now this 20 is calculated and it is returned back. Now from 6, 5, we had selected 6. And after selecting 6, we were calculating the value of 5. So 5 returned a profit of 20. Now what will 6 return? Since 6 is at level 3, so its profit will be 6 into 3, which will be equals to 18. And therefore it will return a profit of 18. And we will add this profit of 5 to this profit of 6 and we'll send it to here. That is to 6, 5. So what it will be? It will be returned as 38 and it will be equals to left. As you can see here that the left hand side calls were made and the values were stored in left. In this case, it will be stored in L equals to 38. By the way, when you had calculated this value 5, then 5 was at index 3. Okay, here 5 was at index 3. If you take this array and say DP at start equals to 3 and end equals to 3, then that array will be equals to 5 only. Okay, in this case. So the DP table is not actually storing the array value, but the profit on selling this array value. So in this case, you can see that the profit was 20. So we will go to DP at 33 and fill this by value 20. Therefore, this value is calculated. Now when this value is returned back to 6, 5, then the left hand side value is only calculated, but we want to calculate the value of right hand side. So again this call will be made to 6. Now 5 was selected, okay, and then 6 will be selected. 6 was the last element, so what will be the profit? It is in 4th year, so it will be 6 into 4, which will be 24. Now 24 will be returned back and it will again go back to 6, 5. But from 6, 5 you had already selected this 5, so the profit for this 5, since it is at level 3, that is y equals to 3, it will be 5 into 3, which will be 15, and 15 will be added to 24 in order to get the total profit, and this will be equals to 39. So in this case, at 6,5 you had L equals to 38, and here the value returned will be R equals to 39. Okay, so the value which was returned from left hand side is 38, from right hand side it will be R equals to 39. Now from this code, as you can see, if the DP value was not stored, then it will not be returned in the first line and the entire things will be processed. After processing, you will be storing the max of left comma right in your DP table from S to E. So in this case, you can see that S is equals to element 6 and E is equals to element 5. So what is your starting point? Starting point will be this element. It will be 2 and ending point will be 3. Okay. So DP at 2, 3 will be DP at 2, 3 will be equals to the maximum of left comma right. In this case, the left is 38 and right is 39. So it will be equals to 39. So we will go to DP at 2, 3 and we will fill it by the value 39. Okay. In this way, we can fill all the values from this tree into this table, and then whatever comes at this position at 0, 3 will be the final answer. It will be our answer, because this will be our starting point 0. We want to calculate from 0. We want to calculate from 0 to 3 in order to include this entire array. So whatever comes from 0 to this 3 in order to cover the entire array, this will be our answer. This cell will give our answer. So I will not calculate the entire thing since it will be very hectic and very time consuming. So my goal was only to explain you how it works and why the DP approach will be working. You can see that here 4,6 is being repeated. So in this case, nothing will be calculated below this point, but the already calculated value will be returned. Okay. And in this case as well, for 6 also, no computation will be required. Since I have taken a very small example, therefore you will not see the full benefit of the dynamic programming. But if you take a larger example, then you can see many of the repeating problems, and so they will not be calculated again, and therefore the time complexity for this process will come out to be order of n square. So this is a slightly different kind of DP. In this case, we call it memoization. In memoization, we are actually solving this by using this recursive approach only. But the only trick which we are using here, which we didn't use in backtracking and recursion, was that we are saving the solutions in a DP table. This is the only thing which is different from backtracking in this case. So I hope you are able to understand this concept, and if you have any type of doubt, then feel free to comment below and I'll try to help you as soon as possible. Like and share our video and subscribe to our channel in order to watch more of these programming videos. See you on our next video. Thank you.